Hi friends, I'm Shivani Jain and I am a French language teacher. I have done masters in French from Bangalore University, Bangalore, and I have written French books as well. So I have been an author and an editor in French. So I am going to start a series wherein we will be learning French. So there will be all the levels. In the first class, I will be starting with the topic L'alphabet, the alphabet. So guys, before starting the class, I would just like to clear one misconception which is, you know, prevailing mostly everywhere. So as we know, there are these letters A, B, C, D. You know, generally people call them as alphabets, like A is an alphabet, B is an alphabet. No, that's a big misconception. A, B, C, D, they are not alphabets, they are the letters. So we have 26 letters in one alphabet. So a group of 26 letters is called an alphabet. So I hope you will not repeat this mistake again by calling A is an alphabet, B is an alphabet. No, like in Hindi we say Varnamala. So Varnamala ek hi hoti hai jisme akshar hote hain. So same ways alphabet ek hota hai jisme 26 letters hote hain. So let's start with the French class. Aujourd'hui on va commencer avec le sujet l'alphabet, the alphabet. So again in French we have same 26 letters as in English, A till Z. So let's start with the pronunciation of the letters. So we have written the letters. So we'll start with A, pronounced as A, A. B as Be, C as Say, D as De. Guys, just note here, in French, we do not have the pronunciation D and T like in English. We call them D and T. So D and T doesn't exist. It's D and T which exist. So we will be doing the letter T later. So D is pronounced as De, E is pronounced as A, F, F, same as English, G is pronounced as J, and H is pronounced as Ash. So now we will be doing one word with these letters. So the word will be in French and there is a pronunciation written in Hindi so that it is easier for you guys to pronounce it and learn it easily. So A is avion, which means aeroplane. B, ballon, a ball. C, chat, a cat. D, dauphin, dauphin, which means dolphin. Then we have with the letter E, examen, examen, exam. F, same in English, the word is fille, fille, girl. G, garçon, garçon means boy. And H, the word is homme, which means man. So guys, your H is not pronounced. When I'll be teaching you the topic vowel, then I will be telling you why we are not pronouncing the letter H. So we call it homme, homme, which means man. I is pronounced as E. J is pronounced as G. So guys, I told you about that G is pronounced as J and J is pronounced as G. So this you have to remember. So G is pronounced as J and J is pronounced as G. So G as J and J as G. It's G. It's the word like measure, treasure, pleasure, that is je. So I will prefer putting two dots here, which means je. J. K is ka. L, L, same as English. M as M. N as N, same as English. O as O, again same as English. P is pronounced as pay. Q is pronounced as Q. Q. A very little sound as O. Q. So now we will be doing the words starting with these letters. So E, we have a word as image. So in French it is image. The spelling is same but the pronunciation is different. Since I is E, so we will pronounce it as image. Image, which means image or a picture. Next is J, we pronounce it as J. A word from J is jardin. Jardin, which means a garden. Ka, the word is kangourou. Kangourou, it is a kangaroo in English. Then we have lion. Again, the spelling is same as English, but the pronunciation is different. So as I is E, so we pronounce it as lion. Lion, which means lion. Then we have M. M is magicien. Magicien, which means a magician. N for need, a nest. Then we have orange. Orange, which means an orange. Then we have, with P, it's pomme, which means an apple. Then with Q, we have K. K, which means a Q or a line. So next is R, you pronounce it as air. S as S, same in English. T is pronounced as T. Guys, if you remember, I told you that D and T, they are not pronounced as D and T in French. They are pronounced as de and te. The sound is the, the, so this is dadi. And the sound for T is te, the for tota. So for every time, whenever you see the letters D and T, you do not have to get confused with the pronunciation. It is the and the, always in French. So T is te. U is U. V is V. W is pronounced as W. X is pronounced as X. Y is pronounced as Y. And Z is pronounced as Z. So now we will be doing one word with each letter. So the letter R, we have the word hra, hra, which means a rat. S, we have stilo, 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 which means a pen. Tomate, tomate, tomato. A means one. Then we have V, we have vache, which means a cow. With W, we have wagon, wagon, which means wagon or a coach. Guys, there is a little difference between V and W. So it is a little English thing. I would just like to make you aware. So when you pronounce V, it is V. The teeth are coming on the lips. But when we pronounce W, it is W, W. There is a shape like O, W. The same is here. V is Vash, Vash. And Vago is Wago, Wago. Then we come to the next letter, X, which is X. We pronounce it as xylophone, which means xylophone in English. Then we have the letter Y, which is Y. The word is Y, which means eyes. Then the last letter is Z, which is Z. Zebra, zebra, which means a zebra. So I hope you like the video.